The Sony A9 III global shutter sensor is revolutionary for filmmakers, and I believe that the A9 III shows us the direction where Sony's cameras are headed. So if you are a filmmaker that is wondering why this sensor is such a big deal and what this sensor means for future Sony cameras like the A7S IV or FX3 Mark II, etc., keep watching because Sony has essentially showed us their roadmap. So here's where we are. At the time of making this video in 2023, Sony has upgraded literally all of their existing camera lines, as well as added several more, so that all of them are now capable of recording 10-bit video in 4K at up to 60 frames per second with amazing autofocus and pretty darn good low light performance across the board. This led to me, as well as many other filmmakers, possibly you as well, wondering what is next for Sony cameras? What could they possibly do to these cameras that would make them better than they already are? I made a video a while ago about what I would like to see from the A7S IV or FX3 Mark II, and in that video, I said that I would love to see things like internal RAW. But that said, with the A9 III, Sony has showed that they're going in a really new and exciting direction. One that I don't think many filmmakers saw coming, and one that has dramatic implications for not only the future of their cameras, but also really has me wondering about how their competition are going to react. That big update was the addition of a camera sensor with a global shutter. Now, if you're confused what the heck that is and what that means, let me break it down for you. Up until this point, pretty much every single DSLR or mirrorless camera that you could purchase used a sensor with a rolling shutter, which would, in essence, essentially record a photo or video by recording data to the pixels from the top to the bottom of the sensor. Some camera recorded these pixels faster from the top to bottom, some recorded them slower, and if a camera was too slow to record these pixels from top to bottom, you would get a phenomenon known as rolling shutter, where if you were quickly panning your camera from left to right, you would experience wavy-looking effects on your footage, where the lines in the footage that should be straight looked kind of curved. So this effect was also called rolling shutter. So yes, you have rolling shutter sensors causing a rolling shutter effect. I know it's weird. Please try to keep up. You could especially see this in cameras that filmed in 8K, which is still a relatively new resolution. And if you start panning those cameras fast, you're usually going to see some rolling shutter. This led to many camera companies putting faster and faster processors into their cameras to make them capable of refreshing the sensor faster and faster to minimize this rolling shutter ripple effect. With a camera like the A7S III having very minimal rolling shutter, which was great. That said though, what was not great is that all of these cameras had another big issue when it comes to this sensor with rolling shutter. This issue is something that you have inevitably faced if you've ever filmed a scene that you do not have full control over the lighting. And that is that these rolling shutter sensors are prone to making lights flicker in their footage. So if you're filming a wedding, for example, and the DJ or venue has really cheap up lighting that is dimmed down, this can oftentimes result in you having really bad flicker, where lights that look solid to your eyes are blinking in your footage. Or you get these really large rolling bands moving down your footage and they look awful. Side note, if you want to know how to fix these two issues, I have tutorials about how to fix both flicker and rolling shutter bands in your editing software, and I would love for you to check those videos out. I will link to them down in the video description. So, in short, these are two big issues with rolling shutter sensors that pretty much all filmmakers have had to work around if they want to use a modern mirrorless camera. That is, unless you choose to use a camera that had a different type of shutter, a global shutter. What makes this sensor different from any other rolling shutter sensor that records pixels from top to bottom, a global shutter sensor is capable of recording every single pixel simultaneously. And this has some major benefits, especially for filmmakers. Here are the biggest. First, because every single pixel is being recorded at the exact same time, a sensor with a global shutter will have zero rolling shutter. No matter how fast you're whipping your camera back and forth from side to side or filming something that is fast moving, you will not see even a slight amount of rolling shutter because it is not possible for this sort of sensor to have that issue. Next, my wedding filmmaker friends are going to love this. If you have ever worked with a flash happy photographer that is taking tons of photos and firing off the flash constantly, you know what I'm talking about. going crazy. I am sure that you have dealt with screen tearing before, where a photographer's flash will take up half of your screen with a white bar, and it could be very annoying and disruptive to your footage to have to fix it. I even have a video showing how to remove photographer's flashes from your footage in Adobe Premiere Pro. I'll link to that video also down in the description. You're getting all of my Flickr and flash remover tutorials in this video. Well, here's where things get crazy, because with the global shutter, you do not need to deal with screen tearing from photographer's flashes anymore. Now, if a photographer's flash goes off while you're recording, instead of the screen tearing, you will simply have a single white frame of your video that you can easily remove without disrupting the overall flow of the video. This is much easier to fix and repair, and I am super excited about it. Keeping on this trend of benefits for wedding filmmakers, you should also know that a camera with a global shutter is going to be significantly less prone to experiencing flicker. So if you have ever dealt with a DJ or wedding venue that has brought cheap LED uplighting that flickers in your footage, or that has the rolling bars that are moving down it, by filming with a global shutter, you are significantly reducing the chances of seeing flicker, because much of that is caused by cameras that do not have global shutters. So now that you can see some of the benefits of using a global shutter for filmmaking, I'm sure you're wondering, are there any drawbacks? Well, yes. There are. In the past, the reason that most camera companies have not opted to offer cameras with global shutters before is because global shutters have typically had worse dynamic range and worse performance. That's why you haven't seen global shutters in any full-frame cameras up to this point. That said, Sony has claimed that they have fixed these drawbacks, and they would not have introduced a camera like the A9 Mark III if they did not think that they had a solution for them. Of course, I had to take their word for it because I've not had the chance to do any in-depth dynamic range tests with this camera. But that said, I want you to be aware that the A9 III does have a higher base ISO than other Sony cameras. Traditionally, Sony has synchronized all of their cameras to have a base ISO of 800 when filming in S-Log 3. But with the A9 III, the base ISO is now up to 2000, which is definitely a jump up. In addition, the A9 III only goes up to a max ISO of 25,600, which is still impressive, but definitely a step down from something like the A7S III. Above all, I want you to remember that this is the first time that we have seen technology like this put into a full-frame camera, and that makes this really the first generation of this technology from Sony. I would not be surprised to see them iterate on this quickly, and we could potentially see massive improvements to things like the base ISO and maximum ISO in future cameras. Above all, here is the question that I have that is still unanswered, and this is where we need to talk about the roadmap for the future of Sony cameras, because I want you to keep this question in mind as you look at the A9 III, as well as any future cameras that Sony is releasing. The question is, are we going to see Sony add global shutter to all of their future cameras? Do they feel confident enough to release an A1 Mark II with a global shutter? What about the successor to the A7S III or the FX3 Mark II? Will those have global shutter? Personally, if they can make these cameras hit the same dynamic range and low light capabilities that they've been known for, I think that the benefits of using a global shutter are completely worth it, and I would love to see Sony introduce this technology into all of their future cameras. The deal is, the A9 III is an incredibly powerful camera, but it's also a proof of concept. Sony has a massive lineup of other cameras, and we don't know if they're going to bring this technology to all those cameras, or if they're going to hold it back and continue to develop this technology for years, and possibly just put it in the A9 series and not include it in their other cameras. Here's my prediction, and I have no insider knowledge about this. Sony did not tell me, hey, guess what? We're putting it in everything. They have not told me anything like that. I'm just guessing here, but I would bet that Sony is going to introduce this global shutter technology into cameras like the A7S III and FX3 Mark II, and I don't think that we are going to have to wait too long to see it happen. Remember, at this point, Sony has upgraded literally all of their existing camera lines and added several more, so that all of them are now capable of recording in 10-bit video and in 4K at 60 frames per second with amazing autofocus and pretty darn good low light performance across the board. I'm not sure what other upgrades they could feasibly introduce to their future cameras that would make them compelling, other than introducing a global shutter to them. In short, the A7S III and FX3 and pretty much all of their current lineup are extremely good for video production. And I think that if Sony wants filmmakers to upgrade, and if they want to give them an extremely compelling reason to upgrade, adding a global shutter to pretty much their entire camera lineup is a no-brainer. Speaking of no-brainer, if you're a filmmaker and you're wondering what equipment you should purchase for filmmaking, you gotta check out my gear guide. This is gonna show you all of the equipment that I recommend you purchase for filmmaking, and you can download it completely for free down in the video description. Thanks so much for watching. Are you excited about this new global sensor? Are you gonna be picking up an A9 III for $6,000? I mean, it's expensive, but it's really cool. I don't know, I'm kinda tempted. At the very least, I'm gonna rent one and try it out more. Anyways, let me know. Leave me a comment down below. Thanks so much for watching and have a great day.